Congratulations, man. You just beat Jim Miller. How does that feel?
Yeah, it feels good. It feels right. You know, it feels like I belong here now. You know, I fought a guy, respectfully, a guy on his way out in the first fight who was game, but I don't think too dangerous. I fought an up-and-comer like myself in the second fight, and now I fought a legend. So I'm still going to have all my doubts going into the fights going forward because I'm a human being and a man, but I know that I belong here now.
Out of curiosity, you said you fought an up-and-comer and then legend. Did they feel different in there, fighting both of them? Did they feel different, or was it the same?
No, you know, I think a fight is a fight, and that's something we were talking about, you know, something that my boxing coach always says that it has been great since I started trying to figure out this crazy game was a punch is just a punch and a kick is just a kick. And then when we were getting all hyped up talking about this fight, I was like, I'm adding on to that. I was going to say a fight is just a fight and a man is just a man. And it's true, you know, some are more skilled than others, some are maybe tougher than others in different ways, but he's just another man once we're in there, and it felt that way. Very mean. He definitely had a good game face and ate some damage like it was nothing, but he's just another man, you know, but somebody I respect for sure, and it was an honor to share the cage with him.
Was the performance what you were looking for? That strategy, that play, how it played out?
Yeah, you know, in all the interviews leading up, I said 3-round grind, and sometimes not the most entertaining, and I was trying to make it that way, but first and foremost is we got to put on wins, right? Or nobody's going to, even if people want to see me and they're exciting, they will never see me because you lose a couple here and you're gone. So, yeah, that was the performance I wanted. I wanted to grind them out and get it done any means necessary, and we did.
Specifically, I wanted to ask, did you pull guard in the first round?
Yeah. Where's John Salter? He's going to yell at me later for that.
And do you regret doing that?
No. I got tagged good, and I had a good, first 4 minutes of the round, or 3.5 minutes, and my legs went a little bit, so I made a proper decision. You know, in the past, I've made the mistake of trying to just dip my head and swing back and getting caught, you know? So we knew we wanted to grapple him. Yeah, I didn't want to pull guard, but it worked out in my favor. You know, I had to give an inch, or, you know, a couple steps back to jump forward. So we knew time in the cage was going to favor me. So if I had to concede the end of that first round, I knew I'd get it back in the second. And then when the third hit, I knew I'd dig deeper. So that's kind of what we had to do.
I have to say, you praised his game face. I didn't see you look hurt even in the first round, even when you pulled guard. It didn't seem like he'd hit you.
Yeah, it wasn't like I was going to get knocked out, but I made the right decision there because he's just going to dip his head and throw four more behind it, you know? So I figured I'd test my feet in the grappling realm. And I think what was good about that was I felt his top pressure, which is where he's going to be best. And while he was able to nullify my closed guard, I didn't feel anything that I was hesitant to go to the floor with in the second round, if that makes sense. So I knew if I got on top, I could control him. He didn't feel anything that I don't feel every single day at GMO or Salted Dog Jiu-Jitsu or any of the places that I train.
So with a name like Jim on your record, where do you go from here? What sort of guys are you looking for?
Boring answer, but I go home to my wife and my baby, you know, and get back right back to work. You know, we're going to get back to work on Monday. We're going away for a few days next week, halfway through the week. And then I come back that next Monday and start training like I have a fight again, you know, cardios and everything, sparring twice a week, and wait for the call. You know, that's the role that I'm ready to play here is stay ready all year long. You know, hopefully a couple weeks notice every fight and come back in, take somebody out, kind of like Jim Miller does. Disappear for a little while, keep getting better, keep grinding, and come back out again. But if nobody hears or sees from me between fights for being an idiot, I'm okay with that. You know, I always want to be the best guy I can be and best husband, father, teammate, you know, instructor, whatever I can be, and then come back out and put on a good performance.
Congrats, man.
Thank you.
And just following up quickly with that, I think part of what he was sort of wondering is, now with a guy like Jim, do you think the top 15 guys are the type of guys that you should be seeing at this point, or are you just glad to get other tough challenges?
Yeah, I mean, that's the crazy reward in this game, is you beat a tough guy, you get a tougher guy. But we're fine with that. You know, whatever may come. That was the third fight in my contract. They're 4-fight contracts. Typically, I think you get a new one after 3. So, you know, once I get another contract, I think that is time. I'll probably get a step up in competition with it, but I don't really care. You know, I don't want to think about it. I just want to think about getting better and better and better. And I've had pretty long layoffs between fights, which we kind of talked about on Wednesday when I was in here. But I think it shows. I come back better every time. So just going to get worried about getting better. You know, I'll probably have less time between these next 2 fights. And same thing. Just worry about cramming in a lot of progression in a short period of time.
Well, you kind of answered the question there. I was going to ask you, do you like this pacing then, since you are making good benefit, or would you rather maybe pick up a little bit more fights and a little bit less inactivity in between?
Yeah, I mean, I like to compete. I'm a competitor. I've been competing since I'm 6 years old, and in jiu-jitsu it was like every month, you know, so I like to stay active. But, you know, given the time we're in, if I can come out and, you know, I fought once last year but was supposed to have 2, just like everybody during, you know, this crazy time. I had to back out of the fight because of COVID and everything. So would have fought twice last year. But, you know, if I can come out and get a win, And whenever they bring me back in, I'm just going to be grateful for it because it is a crazy time. There's a lot of guys in the roster now getting called up on short notice. They got to get fights. So I understand there's a pecking order, and I'll come back when they call me.
And definitely those last couple of rounds was very dominant performance. But when you go back and look back, is there anything that stands out that you're really proud of that showed up for you tonight?
Yeah, I think digging deep. You know, I got a little hurt in that first round, but I think I showed the progression in my stand-up, you know. And got a little hurt, made a good decision, I thought, to, you know, be a little defensive and pull back a little bit, and then came back out in the second, got after it, you know. That's something that maybe in the past wouldn't have happened because I didn't have that experience, you know. But now I've been here, I've gotten the cage with some great guys between, you know, where I started at CFFC and, you know, being here now for a couple fights. And I went back to the stool after the first like it never happened and was ready to come out and fight the second like it was the first round of the fight. I think that's the big thing for me is growth, you know. I feel good in here.
And I know you said you want to go back and spend some time with family. How do you celebrate the win with the family?
I'm going to go back and just be happy I'm not in quarantine anymore and give my daughter a big hug and a kiss and my wife and our dogs. And then we're going to go away for a few days to Florida, just get some sunshine. Haven't been away since my honeymoon. So we're going to go away for like 3-4 days and then right back in the gym with my team. That's what I like to do is train. So we don't leave till halfway through the week. So I'll be back in the gym on Monday, you know, hobbling around on this shin from kicking. But that's it, man. I'm a pretty simple guy. I just like to be with my family. We hang out with our friends. We go to church, have a good time, and just celebrate, you know, where we're at in life.
Kind of makes it sound like since it's the last time was your honeymoon, so this is partly for the wife. The days away, this is for the wife, huh?
Yeah, she puts up with a lot. She's an absolute rock star. That's what I said. You know, I like the simplicity of the quarantine fights, but I was like, man, like, I just wish you could be here, you know? She's been through all of it with me, you know? I'm really lucky that I have, you know, fantastic coaches who, you know, have been with me most of my pro career now. But before I even met them, I had her. And we were talking about it yesterday. I'm like, we've gone through fights where, like, you know, I had some coaches who were, like, half in or really didn't know what they were doing. And, like, it's just me and her cutting weight or me and her driving 10 hours to a fight. And, you know, she's put up with a lot, and she's happy to do it. I know somewhere right now she's probably crying watching either this live stream or just still crying from the fight. And, yeah, I owe it all to her, really. So God's blessed me with a great woman in my life, a great child, and just a great life. So I'm just really, really fortunate. And anytime I can talk about them, I'd like to.
Does she sit down and critique the fights afterwards, or is she just happy that you get the win?
No, she probably didn't see half the fight. She probably watched it through her fingers. And what she did see was like driving through a rainstorm with windshield wipers because she's probably crying her eyes out the whole time. So, yeah, no critiques. She's just happy we got the win. And, yeah, we just move on to the next one.
Congrats on the win.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.